GoldMine Marketing, you're probably all familiar with the fact that GoldMine not only, hopefully there's sort of a feedback, back and forth feedback between your sales and your marketing, and that GoldMine takes care of both of them, or has functionality within it that makes it possible to take care of both of those pretty effectively. Where the difficulty usually comes in is in market segmentation. So what I've brought up here, this is a market segmentation report that shows me the leads that I have in my within GoldMine, and these may be leads, these may be sort of post-contact leads, or they may be leads that have just been simply imported into the GoldMine database as you know, possible leads for our sales reps to reach out to. Either way, understanding those leads that you have within the database and doing a market segmentation so that you can direct the appropriate market marketing messages to those segments is very important. So first, of course, is understanding what do I have. So I'll actually, let's do this. I'll go back to a particular year. So these are actually the leads that were added to our database. What we're looking at is, I'm going to back this up. These are all of the leads that we have in our database by year within certain record types. Remember, in the past, I took out ones that didn't apply. Let's remove employees and past clients, probably in vendors as well if we've got them. Yep. And so this is an overview by market segment of our leads that we have in the database. By industry, down the left-hand side, if you've got an industry designation in yours, you may have SIC codes for breaking down your leads. If you don't, by the way, have SIC codes or DUNS numbers, or there are various ways of segmenting by industry your prospects, if you don't have that, you can import that information into your GoldMine data and make it label the existing leads that are in there appropriately so that you can have useful reports like this, so you can understand to what extent are we actually covering the markets that we think we're covering, and what are the, and in this case, what's the quality of the leads that we have within the data, within the GoldMine database. So we've taken, in this case, that score field A, B, and C, and broken it out so that you can actually see what are our A leads within each of these different industries and so on. Of course, you might again take that a step further by sales rep, by whatever appropriate way of understanding your information. So with the market segmentation, of course, there's action that follows with this. A marketing manager who's working with the GoldMine data doesn't just want to know what do I have. They want to actually do a little bit of what I'll call process management. And so we start to kind of go into that next area that I wanted to cover here, which is not just seeing what you have and managing your users internally, but engaging in processing of prospects. So what do I mean by that? So for example, let's say that what we wanted, that we've segmented our data here, and we've segmented our prospects into, in this case, there's actually quite a few different segments. There are 45 different segments. Now we may group these in various ways. We might want to take all of our secondary ones and just leave them in a single column together. That's fine, just to reduce the number of segments that we're going to address. But let's say we have a marketing message that we want to go out to media type companies that are in our database, and we want to get, maybe we'll take all the A, B's, and C's and send one message to all of those. So looking at this, I can easily see, well, how many do I have in each of those segments? Well, I've got 19 A's and 14 B's and 25 C's and so on. Okay, that gives me the ability to actually count up maybe an aggregate and group the ones that I want to send certain messages to, which I think is very important. So in this case, let's say we want to send one message to that's the same to all of the A, B, and C targets within media. Well, I'll use my MasterMine functionality here to just roll those up into a single column. My purpose being, I want to actually address those as a list. So when I double click on that number, I've got the list that I want, that I can take action with. And there's various ways, of course, of working with a list like this. Maybe what I wanted to do is just simply get it into an Excel, a simple Excel list that has name, company, email address, or maybe has name, company, and physical address that I'm going to send out to a mailing house. Or if it's email address, maybe what I want to do really is take this sheet and upload it to Constant Contact. My segmentation was taken care of within the pivot table where I had the information. Now I've got it in a simple list here that can be simply exported. And I'm sure you've all done exports before from GoldMine. You probably don't need me to illustrate that here. But once you've got it inside of Excel, that's the easy part. You can copy and paste it out into an email, into another spreadsheet that you actually send out to your vendor, or actually use the Excel here. If you're using the built-in GoldMine Constant Contact connection, to actually send them from here into send them actually from GoldMine into Constant Contact. Now, Constant Contact does have a way of uploading information from a CSV file or an Excel file. So, and this is an Excel file, so I'm not going to show you that aspect of it. It's just simply a copy paste in that way. But sometimes what you want to do is really identify the targets that you're going to hit inside of GoldMine. So in this case, I actually don't want to exclude some. I'm not going to select only some of the page. I'm going to leave all of the page selected. This page is the full segment that I was working with, and this might be, it might be tens, it might be thousands, might be hundreds of thousands. Excel can handle all of that. And once I identify, though, who I want to be sending this marketing material to, it's easy for me from here to actually send over to GoldMine and say, these are the ones we're going to work for message number one. You know, you would name the message in your case. And so what we're going to do here is an interaction back with GoldMine to actually make a list on the GoldMine side that will now, there are 58 members of that list. So now from GoldMine, we're sort of driving a process. So let me go back to our contacts view here in GoldMine. And, you know, at this point, you might be scheduling an email to go out. Actually, in this case, that would be actions and an email merge. And your email with your email merge, you would choose, of course, what's the message that you're sending. So you would have set that up as a template on the GoldMine side. And the recipient would be the group that I just created on the other side that was called, did I call it message? It's good to remember what you named your group. But if that's the group that you're sending to, you could say okay, and out would go those messages. I won't go into all the different ways that you want to group process things within GoldMine, but you know, suffice it to say that most of the time in GoldMine, your individual users are really just addressing one record at a time. Your marketing manager hopefully is addressing them a little bit more at a time, but having some tools like this will help them to actually address them in large groups very efficiently to get your marketing messages out to the right people. Other thing related to marketing that I wanted to show you, and a fairly common thing, is marketing ROI, figuring out what is the actual value of leads that you have, or of the leads that have been generated through marketing. I hoped I might have a recent version of that right here. I think I don't. Let's see, lead source. So I do have a report that I created a little earlier called Lead Source ROI. So, and this is just just kind of a visual. By the way, let me kind of emphasize, I'm using MasterMine, our own tools here, to illustrate this for you, but hopefully you can understand that even if you have somebody, if you're paying a programmer to make, you know, reports for you, or you've got somebody on staff who makes reports, the types of reports is what's important here. I do it within the context of MasterMine because it's fast and easy and quick to do, but it is, of course, possible to have somebody write you a crystal report that will give you, for example, like we're looking at here, a breakdown of the dollar forecast sales by, in this case, actually we've got both forecast and completed sales in GoldMine by the lead source. So what's the value of that? Well, if you're the marketing manager, of course, this helps to justify your budget, but not just justify, but actually help you figure out where is the best place to spend my budget. If the highest value potential sales that I'm getting out of all of my sales channels is, or of my marketing channels, is trade shows, as shown by the source field that's in GoldMine and the associated leads or the associated forecast sales and completed sales that we have in GoldMine, if you've got that, then you can pretty easily identify, well, okay, by comparing our expenditures in trade shows with our dollars that came out of it for the year or for last year or for some period of time, that allows me to figure out, okay, where is the best place to invest our marketing dollars? And this might, you know, your source field might be very general or sort of grouped like this, or you might really actually have sourcing information kept in GoldMine that gives you a great deal more detail about not only, you know, what were the customer referrals, but who specifically were the referrals that resulted in these sales, you know, to roll that down. Or, you know, further information about, well, how do these sources relate to these specific products that are being sold. In fact, if we included the product field here in our report, which we did, in this case I'll actually take the product groups. So we might have several different product groups represented in our reports. This is that gadgets and widgets that I explained earlier. This is a way of grouping, or we might actually show the individual products that are being sold. So you can, you know, bring that right down to the individual you know, the specific ones within the groups. And so in this case, I'm showing it in detail really so that you can get an idea of various ways of seeing overviews like this. You know, the key thing here is to be flexible and to have a presentation that gives you the valuable knowledge that you need in order to direct your marketing activity, which is, as I've said, you know, more of a process-oriented thing in GoldMine than a management of people kind of issue.